Hey everybody, Dave Monahan, Goodson Tools and Supplies, and it's another Tech Lab Tuesday episode. I promised you I was going to actually grind a flywheel, so I wanted to kind of go through the setup procedure on that. It's a cast steel flywheel, hard as Superman's kneecap, so I'm going to use the salt and pepper stone on it. But a couple of things I want you to be aware of prior to mounting that is this crankshaft mounting flange on the back of this flywheel. Just like our table surface, needs to be deburred too, because the nuts and bolts you use to mount this to the crankshaft can bugger up this material and cause some burrs. Be sure to knock those down right away. As I mentioned before, our tooling, we've already gone through a deburring process of that. We cleaned up the threads on our mounting bolts and what have you. So you have to find the correct mounting for the back of the crank flywheel right here. Make sure that that is on there correctly. Get that center, and then we allow the flywheel to find itself on top. You can see there's no burrs hindering that setup. Then I can take my centering bolt, my centering cone. Of course, these have all been deburred. These threads have been clean. And I can get that started. Use my T-handle to go ahead and get that mounted in there, give that a nice snugness to it. Make sure I don't have any dowel pins here to get in my way and what have you. And then go ahead and bring my grinding head into position. Get that about, I like to center the grinding wheel over the wear surface that it's gonna have to grind. Just a habit I've got into years ago. All these machines have a locking mechanism in the back so that the head can't move left to right during the grinding process. It's only supposed to move vertically up and down all the way through. Like I said, we've already selected the right flywheel grinding stone for this particular material. I've got fresh coolant in here. I've already dressed this grinding wheel with the machine mounted dresser. I'm very safety conscious, so again, safety first. Don't forget your towel. Make sure you got your face guard on. So we get over here, everything's mounted down. Turn on my machine, get my power going, get my coolant happening, get that table turning, and start the down feeding. The grinding head into the workpiece. So we'll go ahead, feed that down. When I get close, I'm gonna go ahead and fire up the machine. Now, all you people that are watching this video, be sure you got your face shields on, because I'm not gonna put that front guard back in place. My head's locked into position. My table's going, my coolant's going. There's my grinder right there. So let's go ahead. When you get close, you can see the water breaking. I'm ready to start grinding. I've got a good shower of spark coming out of here. That means I'm being aggressive with the grinding wheel against the workpiece. I take the piece in until it's all cleaned up all the way around. What I like to do at the end, I'm going to let that spark out a little bit more. I'll back that off about 2,000. I'll let that go ahead and spark out a little bit. By sparking out, it actually improves the finish. When I'm done grinding, I'm gonna back that baby off, set everything down, clean it off, get my grinding head out of the way, get my workpiece an inspection. Here's nice and smooth. It's parallel. I haven't measured it yet. It looks to be ground consistently all the way around. And you should be able to do these flat flywheels floor to floor in about 15-20 minutes. That's about all the time it takes. That's why you can make $200 an hour with these machines. The right abrasive, with the right material, good fresh coolant, functional dresser, floor to floor, you should be able to get these done 20 minutes tops. That's how you get $50 a flywheel, about $200 an hour out of this machine. So if you have any other questions, get with us. You can catch us on the web at Goodson.com or call us toll free 800-533-8010. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.